So Erik here again, and another update. You guys asked me what is going on with all these Apple Macintosh computers that you bought. In the first update of this season, I gave you what happened with those two Macintosh SCSI computers, and have a look at that. I will not break any. I'm gonna do any spoilers. But let's introduce another computer and see how that works. So this is the Macintosh Centris 650. And what's on top is the display, 14 inch, I don't know, photogenic, gunk.
And how you hear chirping sounds.
Welcome to Macintosh, and in Dutch, by the way. So it's booting.
In full color.
In color, yeah. Which system is this? Didn't see. 8.6 or something, or 9?
I didn't look.
Yay, that's wonderful. The Centris 650 worked. We were very happy, as you can see.
Okay. Cool.
But we realized that to get the other computers working, we had to get some external hard disk connected. And for that, I needed a SCSI cable, which was not in the hall that we had, so I had to order that one, and I found one online. Oh, that's nice. So I did buy this cable. SCSI cable. What I like about it is that it's nice and clean. What I also like about it is that he put in a Terminator, which I don't remember was in the deal apparently, or he just added it, so I'm happy. What I don't like is that it's pretty short, so I have to see how I can position the drive versus the computer, but we will manage, but nice. I've asked Edwin to be here. Hi, Edwin.
Hello.
And what we did is we unboxed again the Performa 450 that we got from a friend of ours, and turned it on. We attached the mouse now. Unfortunately, I cannot film the screen, so that will be a bit problematic. But what we're going to do is try to get the data from this computer, because I promised that. She has some emails on it that she hopes that we can save. Our goal is to try to attach a CD burner to it via SCSI, and hopefully the software has software on it to burn CDs, but that's a bit doubtful because there's no internal burner. So we have to get some software on it as well, like Toast or Gear, and then we might be able to burn the CD with the stuff that's on the disk. So there's an adapter Toast 4. Something for System 7.1, which is running on this Mac. So we're downloading it on an old MacBook that still has a CD burner inside, and let's hope we can get adaptive toast on a CD. So what I now have to do is fetch a CD drive with SCSI to connect to this Mac. My box of SCSI goodness. This is the right cable. And we need a CD burner. I'm trying to find one that doesn't need a caddy to load a CD. Let's see, CD, recordable, rewritable, Yamaha drive. Oh no, that has two modern connectors. I don't have the right cable. I also have this CD recordable that has the right cable. So I'm going to take this one and the cable.
So the problem is we can't open the 7-zip file we just downloaded on this old Macintosh. So we have to transfer the unzipped file somewhere and download it on the Mac.
Okay.
SID file, it is now on this old Mac.
So what I did in the meantime is I plugged in the CD burner to the external SCSI, and it chose SCSI 82. I didn't look what the internal hard disk was, so I hope they don't interfere. Strangely, that CD burner didn't show. So we connected another burner as well, and we had to put it on top of each other just because we didn't have the right SCSI cables otherwise. Some major SCSI chain going on here.
Yeah, but so far no luck.
Okay, so we introduced another Mac Performa 475. And why did we do that?
Well, we had some trouble trying to get the SCSI drives to work. Yeah, we didn't see anything.
We tried two SCSI burners, Yamaha and LaCie, who, by the way, look rather identical, to be honest. And we even tried this standard CD-ROM drive, not even a recordable for Apple. We tried two different SCSI terminators and two different SCSI cables. And in none of the cases was this Performa 450 able to load or to see whether for that reason the CD. We weren't able to mount any. And I just used some standard CDs that were from a French Mac magazine. And none of them loaded or opened up. So we cannot get anything on or off the computer. So what are we going to try now is we're going to try this with another Mac Performa to see if it's a hardware issue, and if we can get it to work here, then what we will be able to do is get the hard disk from the 450, put it in an external SCSI box and mount it on this Performa 475.
Let's see.
Okay,
board looks clean, so
yeah. Yeah, what are we going to try immediately? Recordable, rewritable, or?
Let's start with this one.
Let's start with this one. Yeah, maybe we can try now all the cables and all the CD drives that we have.
Yep.
So at least we know that these work.
Screen's on.
The screen should be on. I didn't turn it off.
Let's see. Oh.
Yep. Yeah, well, so what's the problem? The 475 display doesn't work. So that's another problem. That's not what we're out to solve today, so we'll make a note of that and try another Mac. Luckily we have enough Macintosh computers to test something, so we have the Centris 650. We connected the screen again. If the screen now doesn't work again, then we blew up the screen. Although this has an internal CD drive, we did connect the external one just to test it and to see if the SCSI cable works. We have screen. Let's see if the all the SCSI cables and the SCSI writers work, and then I will get a box to put in the hard disk from the Performa 450, and we will mount that on this Centris 650. So if you can test all the SCSI CDs.
Will do.
I will get the box. Okay, it's half an hour later, and what happened is the following. So we had a Centris 650 we connected, and it's here, back in the plastic, because it booted. And what we tried is we tried the bottom CD player, the Apple CD player. That worked. And as soon as we connected one of the more modern CD recordables, rewritables, that didn't work, and then suddenly the Centris 650 failed to boot from its external hard disk. So instead of solving one problem with it, we created another problem. So the strange problem that we seem to be running into is that this SCSI burner and or the cable are somehow messing up the internal SCSI of these machines. So I'm getting more and more anxious on putting on these external burners or hard disks, because I think I'm blowing up somehow the internal hard disk of this system. So if you guys can have any idea what's going on, then let me know in the comments, because we haven't solved that problem yet. We're going to take a break and consider our options, because they are getting fewer and fewer. So we have Performa 450, where it seems like the external SCSI is not working. We have a couple of SCSI cables. We have two recorders and SCSI that seem not to be working with these older Macintoshes. And the bottom standard old CD drive seems to work with one of the three we tested. Now it's zero because the system failed. So we're running out of options here. So it's time to grab a drink, have a break, and think about what we can do. So limited success so far. So this is getting a bit tedious perhaps, but hey, you asked for an update and this is what you get. So this was part two of three. In the next update, I will introduce a big Quadro E40 power beast, which has internal SCSI, to see if we can solve that SCSI problem. And also the nice thing about it is that we will be able to do networking. So stick around if you're interested. Stay safe. Bye for now.